Good morning, children. Welcome to class 4, and I am your social studies miss. As you are aware that we all have to stay indoors now for our safety, so we are studying in this method. Our first chapter is Sources of History. Now turn to page 16. First of all, we have to know what is history. History is the study of the past, what has already happened and about people who lived on earth before us. And the people who study history are called historians. In this chapter, we will learn about the various sources of history. What are they? Coins, artifacts and monuments, written material and oral sources. First of all, we will study about the coins. Coins give us a lot of information. You can do this at home. Take two coins of the same value and you will find the value of this coin is 1 rupee. Below it, the year written, that is 2016. Then the name of the country India, and in the language written is Hindi and English. So what we learn? The country it belongs to, the value of the coin, the year in which it was made, and the language. The earliest coins were not very well, but now coin making got better over the centuries. Now the coins are made of copper, nickel and zinc. Next, we come to know about the artifacts and monuments. Things made and used by earlier people are called artifacts. Underline this sentence. Household goods, things made of clay like dishes or toys, jewelry and coins are some artifacts that have been found. The study of such artifacts and of the buildings of earlier times are known as archaeology. And the expert of archaeology is an archaeologist. From the artifacts, archaeologists learn how the people of the earlier times lived. Like a clay toy with wheels tells the archaeologist that the people knew how to use clay to make toys. The artifacts were buried underground. Archaeologists uncovered them by digging very carefully. People also left behind buildings which can still be seen. These historical buildings are called monuments. We learn a great deal from such monuments. Then comes about written records or written materials of the earlier times. Sometimes these written materials were written in a language called the Sanskrit that people could read. Many ancient books were written in Sanskrit. But there were other languages which nobody could read. It was like a secret writing. Then written records were of different types. Sometimes a king or someone else in his court wrote about his rule. In this way, we came to know about the rulers like Babur and Akbar. Then there were people who were not rulers, wrote about their lives or about the times in which they lived. Then there were some foreigners who visited India and wrote about the places they visited and described the things that they saw. Their writings were also a source of information about India's history. Then about the religious books also gave us some idea of the earlier times. Like the Vedas are Hindu religious books written by early people called the Aryans. Underline this sentence. Then there were written records found on the rocks, stones or metals. These are called inscriptions. Underline this sentence. They also give us information of the past. We come to know about Ashoka, who was born 2300 years ago through such inscriptions. Now our last information is oral sources. that is from stories, songs and poems. These were told verbally, not through written. They were not written, but they were told verbally. These are called oral sources, like songs, like poems, like folk tales, all tell us about people's lives or of historical events that has already happened. From these, historians learn about things which may not be found in written records. Now, why is it need to preserve all these sources? Every source can tell a story. By looking at sources carefully and trying to understand them, archaeologists and historians get a picture of the people and events of the past. So, everybody should realize how important it is to take care of these sources. Archaeologists, historians and other people all need to look after the historical sources. They preserved knowledge for us all. This is very important. So we end this chapter here.